It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It is no ordinary Thursday, I can tell you that much.
No,
now,
so.
When the first episode of a little program called Noot for Noot Ed in 1991, it would be safe to say that its creators, Johan Stemmet and Johan van Rensburg, did not anticipate that it would become the country's longest running TV game show. Ever. It is now time for the legendary host, Mr. Ntate Johan Stemmet, to hand over the reins as presenter. And tonight, we will be seeing Emo Adams step up into that spotlight as the first episode of season 44 airs on SABC2. But ladies and gentlemen, for now, please welcome the inimitable Ntate Johan Stemmet.
Look at you. Look at
you. You guys have got a way of making somebody feel very important.
But you are.
Even if you're not. Very important.
I always love to tell the story when people talk about somebody being famous or somebody. You know, the only thing that makes us in this game that we are more famous than a guy who's busy baking bread somewhere or busy serving somebody coffee somewhere is more people see us work than they do see him work.
Exactly. True.
But it doesn't make you... I'll tell you what a legend is. A legend is somebody like Chris Barnard who can transplant the heart.
Wow.
But in our game, we just have fun. Mm. And we're grateful that people watch us having fun. And enjoy it while the ride is there, because it goes very quickly.
And for you to say that is humbling on so many levels. As I sit here just listening to your voice, I've got about a million questions all rifling through my head, trying to distill into one, one most important question. And maybe you've hit the nail on the head here. How do you keep it fun? How do you keep it? Is that the key?
It's so simple. No, but it's so simple, because if you enjoy what you're doing, people love what you're doing. People love what you're doing if you enjoy what you're doing.
Yeah.
And, you know, we're not involved with politics, we're not involved with religion, we're not involved with anything but music and games. Mm-hmm. We're just having fun. So if you don't have fun, what are you doing there?
That's true.
And it all comes down to enjoying what you're doing, and then people love watching you and love taking
part. Clearly you've really enjoyed what you're doing, because
for a long time
people have really loved watching you, man.
That's very kind of you.
I wonder how many people actually know the backstory, but when you and your aunt were coming up with the idea of Noot for Noot, just before that, you know, before we knew of the show on air, what was happening? Where was Johan Stemmet? What was life like, and what led you to that moment?
It was just a natural thing. I was a school teacher at Rondebosch Boys IA in Cape Town.
Oh, wow.
And I taught there for about 7 years. And I was writing songs and performing at a hotel here in Stellenbosch for many, many 10 years, every Friday and Saturday night.
Yeah.
One-man band singing, performing, and writing songs. And there was a movement in the late 70s called the Musiek en Lyriek Beweging. It was a movement to get new Afrikaans songs and new music going. And I was part of the crowd, and I was invited up to Johannesburg to take part in a symposium on this. And while I was there, they offered me a job as a music producer in a thing called television, which was very new. It was 3 years old, and we were still trying to figure out what is this television thing? How do you make television? And I started working there. I worked for 9 years at the SABC, and then we were three, Johan van Rensburg, Elsa Colling, and myself. Elsa's been working with me for 33 years already.
Wow.
And the three of us left SABC. We started the first outside production house. Everything was done in the SABC back in the 80s.
Word. You mavericks.
So we broke away, and we started our own production house, and obviously music was our thing, because we'd done a lot of music programs in those days. Stuff that was long before your time, called Platenprijs and Teletreffers and we did all these things in music programs, and the natural thing was to go and do this outside. And SABC one day phoned us and said they needed game shows. Do we want to take part in a symposium once again to talk about how do you make game shows? And we said, of course we know how to make game shows. And we didn't.
That's the key to good TV right there.
It just happened. Certain things in your life gets given to you.
Yeah.
The universe just gives
There's
it to
a
you.
Sense
and,
of providence,
and Noot for Noot was one of those things that was just given to us.
And it's been a gift to the nation as well over so many years. This, oh man. When I just think back to like Friday nights at home, sitting with my late grandmother and grandfather and just not hardly as a child being able to understand what was going on, but feeling like I was part of this that was happening and watching you and thinking, how cool is that man? I want to be like that one day.
Can you see what's going down on screen right
and
now?
When I think about it, when I went to my first TV audition, also just having no idea how to be a presenter, but I, you know, having watched presenters over the years, you were one of the pictures that came up in my mind that, that's what a presenter is. That's what I need to do and be to be a presenter. And I modeled myself according to you, sir. And you're such an inspiration.
Well, that's I don't know what to say. But you know, it's always been experimental. You don't know, you still don't know what makes a presenter. I look at you guys and I think, wow, you go live out every morning and look at you, how easy you are with the cameras, with the auto cues. You just, I always say auto cues difficult to work with because you can't read it. You read it with your mind, not with your eyes.
That's exactly
the way that you guys handle a morning live show is brilliant. It's really brilliant.
In 30 years of my career, I've been trying to say the words that you've just said. The amount of people trying to explain to them how difficult auto cue actually is and that it's not a crutch. You've hit the nail on the head. So all of this being considered, Johan, how difficult is it going to be stepping off that stage?
No.
I mean, you're in the process of. How are you feeling about the transition?
I really, really am very hyper excited about it. I'm super excited because the thing is, I was just speaking to Katlego just before we went on air just now, and then I said the way I saw my career was you start at a certain place, and you've got to see the end line when you start your career, because if you don't put an end line to your career, you don't know where to go and you don't know how to pace yourself. You can't pace your. It's like somebody who runs a race. If you're going to be running the 400 meters, you see the end line and you pace yourself according to where you're going to finish. Otherwise, you're not going to perform like you can perform.
Peak,
And I'm just grateful that I kept seeing the line coming closer and closer. Maybe I overstepped it a little bit because I mean, I'm reaching towards 70 now, and there should be a time where you must say to yourself, listen, but the time was just right. The right people came along. I mean, with Imo and Rochelle, I'm telling you, wait till you see the show tonight. They're going to take Noot for Noot to a level where I've never even dreamed it could go.
Wow.
It's really very exciting.
What an honor.
I hope Imo's taking that on board now.
Oh, he is. He's nervously walking around the cameras and sipping on that coffee. We're going to chat to him shortly as well.
I don't know why I'm feeling all emotional right now, but it's an incredible honor for us to have you guys here to be a part of this transition. I think we are so excited. I know you are still very much a part of the DNA of the show, so that's not going to change. But thank you so much for making us feel like big kids again.
Absolutely love you.
Thank you.
My smile is really stretching all around my head.
Starting to cramp a little bit.
And I can't wait to have Imo Adams on the couch as well, alongside Ntate Johan Stemmet, as we chat about the new era that is Noot for Noot on our televisions. Of course, check out that tonight on SABC2. Season 44, dude.
That's crazy.